Today is Thursday, May 21st, and we're here in the town hall to give an overview of the changes to our health insurance effective July 1st of 2015. My name is Mindy Ernst-Punier, and I'm the treasurer and collector for the town of Southbridge. And with me, I have representatives from MIA, which is Massachusetts Interlocal Insurance Agency, who administers our health insurance, as well as Blue Cross. Just to give you an overview of how we got to where we are with from the plan that we have to the plan that we're going to. When we received our renewal information, our claims warranted a 10.1% increase. It actually warranted a much higher increase. However, MIA was keeping that increase at 10.1%. A 10.1% for a family is a $90 a month increase. So we wanted to mitigate that increase, so we explored changes to our benefits to bring that cost down. The plan that we chose is what's considered a benchmark plan. It's the same plan of as far as co-pays and deductibles that every state employee will be paying effective July 1st. With this change, the town also voted to increase its share of the contribution for active employees from 50% to 60%. That only affects the active employees, not the retirees. The town is also working on a reimbursement plan so that we will reimburse 50% of the out-of-pocket costs. It's still in draft form. It hasn't been signed yet, but we look forward to putting that in place before July 1st. The documents, reimbursement procedure, and forms will be on the town's website. So I'll turn it over to Jill Gallant-Shaw from MIA, and she'll give an overview of our new plan. Jill?
Thanks, Mindy. Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming. With me, I have Tavia from Blue Cross Blue Shield and Jasmine from MIA, and we are here to answer any questions that you have and just explain what will be happening with the plan as of July 1st. So we have a plan design change and an anniversary date change going forward starting the 1st of July. No one has to fill out any paperwork. We will be doing all of the processing behind the scenes, so everybody will just get a brand new Blue Cross Blue Shield ID card sometime between the second and third week of June. And between now and then, if you have questions, we're here today to answer them for you. If you have questions, you're more than welcome to ask them today. And if there's anything that is perhaps private that you prefer not to ask in front of the group, we are more than happy to meet with you after this presentation and answer your questions individually. There are some brochures in the back of the room, so those are really what I'm going to be going through and explaining benefits. So we're going to start actually with the first, which is the Network Blue New England plan. It's called Network Blue New England $300 deductible with hospital choice cost sharing. So it's kind of a long way of saying HMO Blue. So this plan is an HMO plan, and the network is very, very similar to the one that you're currently using under the tiered options plan. The good news is that the tiering gets a little easier on this plan. So instead of having three tiers, you're going to have two tiers of hospitals to keep track of. So we do have a hospital list, a tiering list in the back that will tell you exactly which hospital falls under which tier. Tavia is holding that up for us. Thank you. So this plan has a high cost and a low cost hospital. Harrington Hospital, which of course is what most of us use in this area, is considered a low cost hospital. So that means it'll be a lower copay for you if you use that facility. So I'm going to just go through this summary of benefits for you. As I mentioned, it is an HMO Blue plan. It says Network Blue. The words are really synonymous. Okay. And I'm going to start on this side of the brochure. So one thing that's new this year is a deductible. There is a new plan year deductible for this plan. It's a $300 deductible per person or $900 per family. And I will go through exactly what the deductible applies to and what is not subject to the deductible as well. And then the second line item here shows the plan year out-of-pocket maximum. So I just wanted to explain that an out-of-pocket maximum is not a deductible. So this is not in addition to your deductible. It actually is a cap on how much you will pay out of your pocket in co-pays and deductibles as a total cost for the plan year. So this caps you in a worst case scenario. So should you or your family members be using the plan a lot, this will cap your exposure or your liability. And this is actually a regulation that the Affordable Care Act requires us to put onto the plan. So it's a $2,500 per member or $5,000 per family out of pocket maximum. And actually this year, there is a new out-of-pocket maximum in addition to this for prescription drug copays. Prescription drug copays, which is actually on the back of this brochure, I will get to that, has a $1,000 out-of-pocket max per member or $2,000 per family. So that really means that in the worst case scenario, the most you'll pay in copays per person in a year is $1,000 or $2,000 per family. And again, that is an Affordable Care Act regulation. And these levels are actually quite a bit lower than what the feds set as the highest you can go. So it's still a very rich benefit, and Blue Cross and Maya did put a lot of thought into making these benefits attractive and rich for you. So I'm going to just go through the covered services and what the copays and deductibles apply to. So the first section shows you preventive care or routine services. And again, another Affordable Care Act regulation does require zero copay or zero cost share for preventive care services. And so those would include well child visits, routine adult physicals, including lab tests, routine GYN exams, also including lab tests, one per calendar year, routine hearing exams, routine vision exams every 24 months, and family planning services. Also included are routine hearing exams, including tests. And all of those services have no copay or no cost share and are not subject to the deductible. So if you're going for a doctor visit for a routine, or if you're bringing your child, the deductible will not apply. Okay, and then in addition to that, we have a hearing aid benefit. This plan generously provides a $5,000 hearing aid benefit per year for every 36 months. Was there a question?
Yes, I have a question about the routine vision exam. Does it matter which doctor you go to?
You do have to see a participating provider in the HMO Blue New England network.
I can repeat
the question, sure. The question is the vision benefit require you to go to a specific doctor? Is that correct? And the answer is you do have to go to a doctor in the network, but it doesn't necessarily have to be your primary care physician. It could be another PCP or another doctor in the network. Did you want to add anything to that?
So a lot of times people would go to like a Lens Crafters or something. You can find those participating providers on the website, on the Find a Doctor website, which is listed in your packet. For that, you would want to look for an optometrist, because those are the vision doctors, instead of an ophthalmologist, which would be a specialist in sick eyes.
So it's every 24 months, you don't have to pay a copay.
Right.
If you go to just to check your eyes, a normal, not a specialist.
Right, for a routine service, it's every 24 months. Now, if you have some sort of diagnostic issue like glaucoma or something related to a diagnosis, that is outside of the routine services and would be subject to, in most cases, a copay and or deductible. Okay.
All right, so what you have to do is go on the net, find out the network, to find out who would be, be the right doctor to go to.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Right.
All right. Because right now I go to a specialist, but to avoid that payment, I mean, it doesn't have to be a specialist.
Right.
So I got to kind of shop around, right?
Sure. Now, this plan, I should mention, as an HMO plan, does require you to choose a primary care physician that participates in the network. And typically, your primary care physician will set up a referral or tell you who they would recommend for you to see. So that's what I would recommend, is starting with your primary care physician. to see who's in the area in the network.
Thank you.
Sure. The next benefit is the emergency room coverage. You can go to any emergency room anywhere in the country. There is no network because we never know when or where an emergency is going to occur. So it is a $100 copay after your deductible. Your copay will be waived if you do happen to be admitted to the hospital for an observation stay. However, once that deductible or once that copay is waived, you would then pay the inpatient copay. And so that is where the plan tiers the hospital. So it depends on which hospital you're going to. If you go to a low-cost hospital, it's a $275 copay per admission after your deductible. Or if you go to a high-cost hospital, such as UMass, for instance, that would be a $1,500 copay after your deductible. So you can see that it's important to understand exactly which hospitals are in each tier, probably in advance of going to them, just to have a plan. So then going back up to the outpatient care, mental health and substance abuse treatment, you do not need a referral. You can just go just as long as it is a facility or physician that is in the network. And it's a $20 copay and no deductible applies. For office visits, whether you're going to a primary care physician, an OBGYN, a network nurse practitioner, or a nurse midwife, it's a $20 office visit copay and no deductible applies. And if you're going to see any other type of physician, a specialist, it would be a $60 copay and no deductible applies. You would want to make sure you get a referral from your primary care physician to see a specialist. For chiropractic office visits, this plan covers up to 20 visits per calendar year, and it's a $20 copay with no deductible applying. And actually, this is one of those services that you do not need a referral. Again, you just need to see a participating provider in the HMO Blue New England network. Okay. Short-term rehab therapy, physical therapy, occupational therapy, all provide 30 visits per calendar year. At a $20 copay and no deductible would apply. Again, you just need to see somebody that's participating in the network. Speech, hearing, and language therapy, again, $20 office visit copay and no deductible to a network provider. Surgery. If you're having surgery in a primary care physician's office, you're going to be looking at a $20 copay and no deductible would apply. Or if you're having a surgical procedure in an office setting with a specialist, it would be the same $60 office visit copayment with no deductible applying. However, if you are having a surgery that typically requires anesthesia or is an outpatient surgical procedure, at that point you would be looking at a $250 copayment after you've met your deductible. For diagnostic x-rays and other imaging tests, you would have no copay, but they would be subject to the deductible. For high-tech imaging, such as CT scans, MRIs, PET scans, and nuclear cardiac imaging tests, there is a $100 copay per category per date of service after your deductible. For oxygen and equipment, there is no copay and no deductible, or the deductible would apply, but no copay. Same thing with durable medical equipment, such as wheelchairs, hospital beds, crutches, things of that nature. No copay after your deductible. Prosthetic devices, again, no copay once you've met your deductible. And for home health care and hospice services, no copay after your deductible. We've gone over the surgical ambulatory surgery. And then for inpatient care, as I mentioned, that's where we tier the hospitals. So low-cost hospital is $275 and high-cost is $1,500 after your deductible. For a chronic disease care hospital, there is no limit to the amount of days you can be admitted, and there is no copay. after your deductible. And for a mental hospital or a substance abuse facility, again, there is no limit to the number of days you can be admitted for. It's just as many as medically necessary. And that has a $275 copay per admission with no deductible applying. So this is a one case where the tiering does not apply. It's always going to be a $275 copay. And no deductible. A rehab hospital has no copay after your deductible, and a skilled nursing facility covers you up to 45 days per calendar year, and it does have a 20% co-insurance after your deductible. Yes?
There's one line for the diagnostic x-rays that shows nothing after deductible, and then the following line has the same tests with $100 per category per service date.
I can explain that. This actually says that the diagnostic x-rays and other imaging tests those are separate. Those are the high-tech imaging.
Okay.
So CT scans, MRIs, and PET scans are typically much higher cost in nature, so they separate them into their own category. And so those would have a $100 copay.
Okay.
But for x-rays and those types of lab tests, there would be no copay associated.
Okay. Thank you.
Sure. I'm just going to go to the back side of this brochure where it talks about your prescription drug copays. So this plan, as I mentioned, it does have an annual out-of-pocket maximum, which is a new benefit as of this July 1st. So again, $1,000 per person, $2,000 per family, and that is the most you'll pay out of your pocket for prescription drug copays in one plan year. You are still able to go to any retail pharmacy that you've been using or that you choose to go to. That will absolutely remain the same. And you can get a 30-day supply at a retail pharmacy for $10 for Tier 1 generics, $30 for Tier 2 or preferred brand name drugs, or $65 for Tier 3 non-preferred brand name drugs. Now, if you do take any medication on a maintenance basis or something that you take every single day or ongoing, you would definitely want to consider using the Express Scripts mail order program because you can save money and it's very convenient. You can get a 90-day supply of your prescriptions for the price of a 60-day supply. So every quarter, you save a copay on each prescription. So if you were to do that, and I should also mention that the deductible does not apply to prescription drugs. So for the mail order, it would be $25 for generic Tier 1, $75 for preferred brand name or Tier 2, and $165 for non-preferred Tier 3 prescription drugs. So again, I strongly recommend if you haven't taken advantage of the Express Scripts mail order program, we do have brochures that you can use to set up an account, and it's a very convenient way to get your medication and more affordable. I do want to mention that this plan has, both this plan and the PPO plan offer a fitness benefit, which gives you $150 reimbursement per family per year to go to a health club or a gym, and also an additional $150 reimbursement for weight loss if you or anyone in your family goes to Weight Watchers. And those are forms that we can help you with as well, or you can also get off the Blue Cross Blue Shield website. So I've just covered the HMO plan. I also want to bring to your attention that we have another plan, called Blue Care Elect Preferred. This is our PPO plan. And typically, this is a plan that people will choose if they live outside of the New England area or if they have college-age students that are living outside of the area. It covers the exact same benefits as the HMO Blue New England. So there is no difference in how your plan is covered, except it does provide coverage outside of the area, mm-hmm. and you do not have to choose a primary care physician or get a referral. So you do pay a little bit more for this plan to have the benefit of avoiding referrals. But other than that, the coverage is equivalent.
Can you just explain, Joe, we do have several retirees that are out of the area who may watch this tape. Can you just explain, if they are down in Florida, how this being out of network, how using this out of the network affects them.
Sure.
Thank you.
So if you are outside of the network, well, first of all, this is a nationwide network, so it's very hard to go outside of the network. So for instance, if you were traveling or spending time or even live outside of New England, and let's just use Florida as an example, you would be able to use the local Blue Cross Blue Shield network in Florida, and that would be considered in-network, and that would apply to any state that you're in. Mm-hmm. However, if in the off chance that you find a non-participating doctor, somebody that does not accept the PPO plan, you are still covered, but you have more of an out-of-pocket cost. So this plan would actually have a higher deductible for out-of-network services. It would be a $400 per member, $800 per family. And the out-of-pocket maximum is the same. It would either be $2,500 per member, $5,000 per family. So the deductible is slightly higher, and then you would have a 20% co-insurance applied. So it would be 20% of the bill. And in a lot of cases, it's going to be a higher bill than it would be with just your fixed co-payment amount as on the HMO. The only other service that doesn't have the 20% co-insurance would be the emergency room. Again, because we never know when or where an emergency will occur. So that's always going to be a $100 copay after your deductible, no matter which plan you're on. But the prescription drug benefits are exactly the same. And I mean, that's pretty much it. 20% after deductible is the out-of-network coverage. Anybody have any questions?
When you're living in another state, it doesn't have to be Florida or any place else but Massachusetts, is it better to have one plan over the other?
That is really a matter of opinion. So it's difficult to answer that. On a cost basis, the HMO is always going to be more affordable. And again, Blue Cross Blue Shield has an enormous network. They actually have the largest network in the country. It's huge. So on a PPO level, as I mentioned, it's very hard to find someone that doesn't accept the plan. But on the HMO, because you have the New England program, you're able to see doctors in all the New England states. So if somebody is living in Connecticut, it's still considered in the network, or in Rhode Island, or what have you. So my recommendation is, before deciding which plan to choose, just check to see if your doctor and your specialists are in the network, mm-hmm. and that will help you to make that determination. Does that answer your question?
It does, but if you go to another state, you don't know which doctors are out. You'll have to look in for a doctor in case you need a doctor. Mm-hmm. Is that what you're saying?
Right.
So, right, any state outside of New England, you'd have to go to a PPO plan because it's not covered. But if it's in New England, then we advise you to look around and see if HMO is for you. But if you're a snowbird and you go to any other state outside, then we would advise you to go to a PPO.
So if anything happens to a person outside of their network, like in this area where you have your physician, mm-hmm. you just go to the emergency room?
Right. Emergency and urgent care are covered. And then all follow-up care has to be done. If you're on an HMO Blue plan, it has to be done in the network. Even in a PPO plan, it has to be done in the network. But if you're on an HMO Blue plan, then it has to be through your primary care physician and through your core network, mm-hmm. referrals and all that stuff.
So you can still get services outside of where your doctor is, and then come back to where?
Right, even if you go out of the country, it would be that way. You would have to, let's go, if you go to a Spanish-speaking country and you have an emergency, you'd have to get the paperwork translated in English, and then it would go through our referral. Emergencies are emergencies, so mm-hmm. As long as the urgent, all the follow-up care is done within your network, then it's good.
What if you can't do the follow-up in your own network? What if you have to stay where you are because you had a serious emergency and you were admitted to the hospital?
That would still be considered part of the emergency inpatient stay. Yeah, we would never say that you should just leave the hospital to save money. We wouldn't say you've been in the hospital for more than 48 hours, so now we're going to just start charging it as out-of-network. If the doctors can, you know, supply medical necessity evidence saying that you are in this hospital and you need to stay in this hospital, and they're doctors. We will understand that and accept that and pay it. So I just have a few other items that I wanted to bring to your attention. Again, this is the hospital cost sharing list. It's in the back of the room and it will be on the town website, I believe. So this will list out which level your hospital or facility falls under, whether it's a low cost or a high cost facility. And this gets updated periodically, usually once a year. So once we have any updates, we'll make sure that the town is aware of them. It's just a good thing to have. Okay. This is the Blue Care line. Just wanted to bring to your attention, this is actually a benefit that's existing on your current plan, but it's good to have a reminder. The Blue Care line is a 24-hour nurse line that you can call in the event perhaps your doctor's office is closed, maybe it's in the middle of the night on a weekend, and you or someone in your family is experiencing something that you're not sure if maybe you should go to the emergency room and spend several hours sitting there waiting, or maybe wait till your doctor is open again on Monday. This is the perfect example of when you should call the Blue Care line, because a nurse will talk to you, they'll pick up the phone and ask you what your symptoms are and talk you through it, and either recommend that you go to the emergency room right away, or perhaps go to an urgent care facility nearby, or go to a CVS Minute Clinic, or wait to see your doctor on Monday. It's a free service and it's definitely worth calling. I've used it myself when I had an allergic reaction to a medication, and personally can tell you that it was wonderful. I did not have to go to an emergency room. Mm-hmm. She helped me with over-the-counter home remedy medication, and it was great. And then she called me the next day and followed up with me, and also called my doctor's office and let my doctor know that I had had this experience. So personally, I can say that it's a really good program, and I would recommend using it if you can. And then one other sheet that is here is called Avoid Costly and Time-Consuming Trips to the Emergency Room. And this kind of goes back on the nurse line as well. There are some cost and time-saving measures that are available to you that you can do before going to the emergency room, and one would be the nurse line that I just mentioned. That nurse line number is listed on the back of your Blue Cross Blue Shield ID card, so you always have that on you. Okay. And also, there's a low-cost option, which is the CVS Minute Clinic, and the CVS Minute Clinic is, they're privately operated different minute clinics all over the state, but you do not need to call your doctor or get a referral. You just walk in and they can treat you for things such as getting a strep test or a throat culture, conjunctivitis, a flu shot, earaches, those kinds of things. And they can write you a prescription right on the spot, and it's a $20 copay, the same as going to your primary care physician. You can take that prescription and fill it right there at CVS, or you can take it to whatever local pharmacy you like to use. Or if they can't treat you, they'll recommend that you either go to an urgent care facility or to your doctor. And then another option would be going to an urgent care facility. So an urgent care facility is also going to be your $20 office visit copay, and will absolutely be less time consuming and less expensive than going to the emergency room.
Locally, there are minute clinics in both CVS in Charlton and then the CVS in Auburn as well.
And they seem to be becoming more popular. So you can actually go right onto the Blue Cross Blue Shield website or the CVS website, and you can put in your zip code and it will tell you where they're located near you. So that's what I would recommend doing. And as well, the urgent care clinics, it's a good idea to have an idea of where your local urgent care clinics are so that you don't have to be scrambling and wondering where you should go in the event that you're having an urgent situation. So that's just my recommendation.
Also, if you go to an urgent care that is possibly at a hospital, or you're not sure if they're participating, you'll want to call the number on the back of your card, and
get a retroactive referral. So that way we'll know it was an emergency, you didn't know. Maybe you had a serious pain and you didn't know what it was. It turned out to be gas, but you wanted to go see a doctor just in case, and that's completely reasonable. We just ask that in that case you would then call, and that way we could put the authorization on file instead of us finding out because the claim denied and you finding out because you're getting a bill. Because certain urgent cares, if you don't check the website first, even though they're called urgent cares, aren't listed, even though their hospitals might be participating in the network. So if you go to an urgent care and you're not sure that they're participating as an urgent care specifically, give us a call, let us know.
And last but not least, I just wanted to bring to your attention that there is a $9 generic drug program that Blue Cross offers, and there are certain prescriptions. If you go to this, you can actually call the number or go to this website, and it will give you the list of drugs that you can get a 90-day supply for $9. So it's definitely a good deal and worth looking into if you're trying to save a couple of bucks here and there. Mm-hmm. So I think that's it. Are there any questions on the plans or changes? Yes.
Do you know if Express Script calls the home? Because I did have a phone call, but you know, you can't trust all these phone calls anymore. There's so many weird phone calls you get. So is it their format to call the home and say, you know, I want to talk to you about the Express Script Pharmacy, I'm part of Blue Cross Blue Shield. Is that a legit call?
Well, in my experience, usually the Express Scripts will call you when after you've set up an account and that you have an order coming, and they want to confirm that you did indeed order what you requested. I don't know if you want to expand on that.
Yes, sometimes they will call for different reasons. Either there's a delay. As you guys may have heard, sometimes we get snow up here, and sometimes that'll delay medications, and they might call you to let you know that medications won't be arriving as scheduled, and they've put in an authorization for you to get it at a pharmacy instead. They might call you to let you know if your doctor wanted to change the dosing on your prescription, or if it's the last refill that's going to be on your prescription, so they want you to know that you need to speak with your doctor and get a updated prescription moving forward. So yes, sometimes they may call you, but I totally understand if you're wary of them calling. You can always, you know, take that message and then call Blue Cross Blue Shield, make that phone call yourself, and then have us reach out to them and find out what was going on.
The question is, who keeps track of the deductible? And that's a very good question. So if you go to the doctor, the hospital, or what have you, you just show your Blue Cross Blue Shield card, and chances are they're not going to bill you that deductible right on the spot because of the way, just the nature of billing. They're going to send that bill to Blue Cross Blue Shield. And so Blue Cross is ultimately going to be tracking your deductible. Mm-hmm. I would say you can always call Blue Cross to say how much of my deductible have I met, how much is left, what applies to the deductible. And also you can go to the Blue Cross Blue Shield website under member self-service, and you basically set up an account with a username and a login password, and then it'll pull up all your claims and you can see exactly what you've had done and how much of your deductible has been met, how much is, you know, remaining, if you don't want to make a call to member services. But Blue Cross is going to send you an EOB in the mail, which is an evidence of benefits, and it's going to tell you exactly, you know, what the service was that you had, how much it cost total, what the doctor billed Blue Cross, what the allowed amount is, or the negotiated rate that Blue Cross will reimburse the doctor for, and what your responsibility is. So you will get a paper copy of that as well. But I would recommend calling Blue Cross if you're trying to keep track of it.
Thank you.
Do you have a question?
I have one about coordination of benefits. When someone has more than one insurance, like I have an adult son who is working, he has his own insurance. He also has insurance through
my plan because he's under 26 years old. Mm-hmm. So he has two, and when he goes to the doctor, when he goes to CVS, when he goes to physical therapy, everybody coordinates benefits. Mm-hmm. When we go to the mail order company, Express Scripts, they do not coordinate benefits. Okay. And we're actually struggling to understand, first of all, why they won't coordinate benefits and how that can be corrected, because it's just, it's turning into like this kind of big problem for us. Every time there's a script, it's a problem.
So we definitely have a coordination of benefits team at Blue Cross Blue Shield, and they work with not only other insurance companies, but also with Medicare, and it's team members and associates who specialize in working with other insurance companies and making sure that that is as seamless as possible for our members.
And if there's any changes to the dental insurance?
There are no changes to the dental plan.
Besides the premium.
Besides the premium. Another thing I would just mention is when you're looking at this hospital choice cost share, pay attention to this second paragraph under the bullet points, or actually this first paragraph under the bullet points. Mm-hmm. So the high-level overview, it mentions inpatient care, but also these services are also subject to that higher copay, which is inpatient care, outpatient day surgery, outpatient high-tech radiology, outpatient diagnostic lab tests, outpatient diagnostic x-rays, and other imaging tests, and other short-term rehabilitation therapy.
But that's not here. Those copays aren't here.
Yeah, those aren't here. They're just not in this.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Those services that she mentioned are not tiered on our plan. We only have one copay for those.
Okay,
at this
so
point, it's only inpatient.
Only
that has
inpatient.
The high cost, low cost hospital.
But you know, because these plans do have a deductible, it is probably better to go to a low cost facility when you're having those services, because the bill actually will be lower than at a high-cost facility. So even though your copay is going to be the same for most of these services, if the deductible applies, then it actually could end up saving some money. So even though it's not tiered, it's still nice to understand which facilities in general are the lower tier and the higher. So I think that's actually all of the information that we wanted to share today, unless there are other questions.
I actually just have a little bit in closing. At the beginning, any of the handouts that we mentioned today will be on the website. If they're not already, I'll go back tonight and try to make sure those are on before the weekend. And also, on the out-of-pocket maximums that Jill mentioned, and I mentioned briefly at the beginning, there's $1,000, $2,000 out-of-pocket maximum for prescription, $1,000 for the individual, $2,000 for a family, and then the $2,500, $5,000 on the medical out-of-pocket costs. What the town is working on at this point is a reimbursement plan. So once an individual reaches a $1,250 out-of-pocket limit or amount, we will reimburse up to the $2,500 for an individual plan. For a family, once a family reaches a $2,500 out-of-pocket cost, we'll reimburse from the $2,500 one penny to the $5,000 out-of-pocket maximum. We'll also do the same on prescriptions. So what we've committed to, or what we're ironing out the details on, is to reimburse 50% of the out-of-pocket costs for prescriptions and medical. And we'll also continue to reimburse for the second or subsequent inpatient hospital stay within your family. That will only be at the lower cost facility, and we'll also reimburse for the second or subsequent outpatient surgical procedure, which is a $250. There'll be requirements, there'll be procedures that will all be on the website, hopefully within the next couple of weeks, definitely before July 1st. And God willing, nobody will be reaching anywhere near those amounts before next year, maybe at this time. But that is any employee or retiree on a non-Medicare plan is eligible for that reimbursement. So it's everybody on a non-Medicare plan. All of the plans we talked about today are not non-Medicare plans. The senior plans, anybody 65 or over on Medicare Part B,
are on senior plans, and where there are no changes to those plans at this time. Those plans all change for January 1st. So there's no changes to those plans for anybody who may be on those plans. If anybody has questions, please call the office 508-764-5401 or check our website at www.ci.southbridge.ma.us, the Treasurer's page, and Benefits Administration. Thank you.